Chopper to Zach Short. Here's the throw. Down on the bag, and it is over! No heartbreak this year for the Pioneers. Sacred Heart, the NEC baseball champions here in 2015. Their fourth title of all time, and they are going to the NCAA tournament.
But wait, it wasn't that easy. Let's start from the beginning. Sacred Heart started their season down south in Louisiana as they took on Northwestern Louisiana State University to start their season.
Started the Southern trip in, was it Northwestern Louisiana? Rough start for the season. I remember we lost a few tough ones. I think we lost an extra inning game down there.
Sacred Heart dropped their first three games in Northwestern Louisiana, but looked to turn things around moving forward.
We had high hopes and we battled down there. You know, we unfortunately lost all three, but we had a bunch of close games. But from that, we saw that there was a potential to be something great that season. Unfortunately, the next couple games, we got killed.
On the two-hit night, first pitch, and that one is driven in the right field, going back track to the wall, and that is gone! Chaz Boyer clears the bases. That one got out in a hurry. A grand slam. 13-1, Chaz Boyer cranks one.
Sacred Heart finished their Southern trip with an 0-8 record, but by returning home, they look to try and break into the win column.
Pushes it through the left side of the infield, a single in the left. That's going to bring around two runs to score, and Washington State with a 3-1 advantage. Take my
hand through the flame. After struggling early, you know, there's always a little bit of doubt and angst, but I think the guys kept working and working, which was a testament to the way that the team just developed and kept going.
After getting their first win against Fordham, Sacred Heart went 1-14 before they started to turn things around.
So I think early in the year, not that we didn't, you know, I think we felt like we could turn around, but we knew that, you know, we were still trying to figure out who we were, what kind of team we were going to be. And I think early in the year, the struggles maybe helped us find out, you know, what we needed to do.
It was at this point that Sacred Heart began to turn things around. They ended up winning 14 of their next 19 games, trying to make a playoff push heading into the end of the season.
First is in time to throw to third to get Viziano. They got him too on the tag by the catcher Doyle covering.
Here comes the 2-0. Hit in the air, deep to left, north. At the wall, looks up, and it's over the wall onto Ashland Place. LIU falls twice today. Sacred Heart winning the first one by a score of 2-1, and this one, the Pioneers win 6-2.
Going into the last weekend of the season against Central Connecticut, Sacred Heart needed two wins to clinch a playoff berth in the Northeast Conference tournament.
We were catching hot at the right time. That's what it was all about. We knew we had to win these two games, and we knew we could beat Central very easily.
By taking 3 out of 4 against Central Connecticut, Sacred Heart got into the NEC tournament as the 3 seed. They would be facing the number 2 seed Wagner Seahawks, who possessed the pitcher of the year, Nolan Long, and the player of the year, Nick Deeney.
I mean, we felt confident we could beat anyone. I really did. I mean, I think we felt that the whole season. Even when we were 1-14, we still felt like we could win.
Going into that game, my emotions were a little bit everywhere, you know, just as any competitor, they're, you know, they got the butterflies, they're a little bit nervous before they start. But overall, you know, once I started warming up, I got locked in, real focused.
Curveball, backdoor call, strike 3 again. Curveball hit down to third. That stays fair. It's going to be a tough play to make across the diamond, and a great pick at first by Sorrento for the out. But no place to put a runner if he falls behind. That one golfed out toward right field, falling fast, caught at deep second base. Runner's going to tag for second base. The throw is up the chest of Doyle, and a very aggressive play leads to the first run of the game.
Going into the ninth inning, the Pioneers were still trailing 1-0, with Nolan Long still out there on the mound.
I wasn't ready for the losing bracket. You know, it's not over till it's over, especially with this team. I believe we had a solid part of the order coming up, too.
Yeah, I think we felt confident. You know, I think it was just get a base runner on, work from there. You know, I know Zeus was a leadoff guy. He was able to get on base.
And that opened the door for Zach Short.
The handle of the bat, though, deep to left field. That's going to get off the wall. It'll be extra bases. Hitting second is Medina. They're going to send him in for the tying run. The throw not even close, and we've got a new game in game two of the ninth inning. An RBI double off the left field wall by Zach Short, and the All-NEC first teamer comes out of his slumber.
And that set the stage for Cody Doyle.
I think they had one of the, I think he was a reliever of the year on the mound, so I just try to keep it simple and put the ball in play, and luckily, you know, I was able to find a hold on the third baseline.
1-1 fastball. Inside the bag! That'll be at least one run. Second run coming around. Sorrento is going to be safe. The throw is cut off. Down to second goes Cody Doyle. And the freshman breaks through with a game-breaking two-run double in the top of the ninth. 3-1, the Pioneers lead.
The Pioneers pulled off the comfort-behind win, and they gained much-needed momentum moving forward into the winner's bracket.
And Sacred Heart comes from behind in the ninth inning to get the dramatic win here in Game 2.
Yeah, I think that was a big confidence boost. I think, you know, we knew that we had Foley on the mound the next day. Bryant, who was the team we knew we were going to have to beat, lost. I think that was also, you know, another kind of confidence boost that had nothing to do with us, but we knew they were the team, you know, that was going to give us the most trouble.
With Fairleigh Dickinson defeating Bryant in the first round, Sacred Heart moved on to play the number 4 seed in the winner's bracket.
Here's the 3-1. This is swung on and lifted in a deep left field. Back at the track, at the wall. Or no, it goes over the wall, home run. And it's a two-run shot to left. Here's the kick
and the pitch. See you later. 5 strikeouts. Jason Foley, fantastic.
The bats came alive in Game 2 as Sacred Heart rolled over Fairleigh Dickinson 10-0, highlighted by another brilliant pitching performance by Jason Foley and a two-home run game by Zach Short.
It is his second two-run homer of the game.
Bats were going. You know, that's the formula. That was the formula for the win.
Up next, Sacred Heart would be taking on the two-time defending champion and number 1 seed Bryant Bulldogs, needing just one more win to become NEC champions.
The 1-2 is crushed into right field. That's a base hit. And it gets by Byram. Here comes Albanese. He will score. Rinn into third. Bryant takes a 2-0 lead. I don't know if he was sacrificing there with one out, but he rips it into left field. That is a base hit. Zarazny comes through. Mullen scores. Bryant takes a 4-0 lead.
Yeah, I think, you know, we still felt confident. Wirtz wasn't the usual Wirtz. I think he was a guy who had been used to throwing 3 games a weekend. He hadn't thrown in a while. So, you know, he gave up a few hits. They're just a really good hitting team.
Pioneers lost Game 3 to Bryant 5-2, and it would all come down to a winner-take-all game the next day, Championship Sunday.
The 2-1, hit well into left center field. That's a base hit. Shaw scores. Sacred Heart strikes first.
Pioneer struck first with 2 runs, but in the 4th, Bryant struck back.
1-1 in the dirt. That gets away. Runner trying to come home. Throw home, not in time. Hit right to Short, who can't play it. It gets by him. It'll plate the go-ahead run. 2 runs in on the play, and it's 4-2 Bulldogs here in the bottom of the 4th.
The Pioneers were able to come within 1 run, but going into the 9th, they still trailed Bryant 4-3.
Here we are, 9th inning, down a run, and the energy was just, it was electric,
Jason Sullivan led off the 9th inning, needing to get something started, or their season would be over.
Jason Sullivan, the top of the order, hits it hard and fair inside the bag and rolling toward the left field corner. Sullivan has wheels. He's digging. They still can't pick it up. Zarazny has it. Here comes Sullivan into third. He slides. Save. And the 0-2 is looped out into right field. Base hit. We're tied at four. Jesus Medina comes.
And that set the stage for the birthday boy, Victor Sorrento.
Scores him. And there it is, into center field. Base hit for Sorrento. Medina being waved in, the throw, not in time! Sacred Heart takes the lead, 5-4.
That one run was all that Danworks needed as he went out there for the ninth inning to finish the job.
Here's the throw, down on the bag, and it is over! No heartbreak this year for the Pioneers. Sacred Heart, the NEC Baseball Champions here in 2015. Their fourth title of all time, and they are going to the NCAA tournament.